Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is CoinX and you're welcome to CoinX the Producer. Today we have an amazing news from FL Studio Image Line. They just released the version 2025.1 and guys, this is mind-blowing. It came with some super interesting features, upgrades and the rest of it. So I'm going to walk you through the newly introduced features and the ones they upgraded. Trust me, if you're an FL Studio user, you will love this. So with that being said, let's jump right in. FL Studio did an amazing job by introducing up to 500 mixer tracks as against the 125 mixer tracks in the previous version. Simply come over to this icon right here, click on it to add more tracks, or right click to utilize the options here. As you can see, add multiple, click on that and now state the number of tracks you want. Let's say 300. Very interesting. So you can either add from this icon here or come over to this section here to add, as you can see. Now, another beautiful feature existing on this mixer in the latest version of FL Studio is you can trim unused tracks and decide to remove, as you can see, 306 unused tracks. You click on yes and it is gone in one click. And according to Image Line, the mixer tracks are dynamic, so you can decide to hide or review the tracks you want. And on this latest version, you can undo multiple sessions of the mixer tracks you added without having any challenge. This is a big win for FL Studio users. Now you have more mixer tracks to work with. This feature changes everything. I mean, it is mind-blowing and it takes FL Studio to the next level. Let me show you. In the previous versions of FL Studio, for you to edit a certain portion in a recorded audio, you need to, like, let's say cut here and you want to edit this portion. For you to do that without affecting the entire audio, you need to make this, click here and make it unique, right? That was how you can do it without affecting the entire audio. But right now in this latest version 25, you don't need to go through those hassle. All you need to do is, let's say you want to manipulate there, but before then, let me preview the audio we are to work with. Alright, let me change the pitch right here by holding down Alt and double clicking. So we'll bring this pitch down. Now let me split it the more. Alright, so double click holding Alt and drag this to the left to bring it down. Then this particular one, hold down Alt, double click. Okay, I want to reverse this one. Nice. And then this last one comes back to normal. So let's have a quick listen. Amazing. I mean, with this, you can do some crazy things with your audio and come out with a very unique output. Alright, here is another jaw-dropping feature inside FL Studio 25. Let's say you want to start a project, but for some reason you are lacking inspirations or ideas. FL Studio 25 made it a lot easier for you to kickstart. Now, all you need to do is to head over to this section here. Right above here, you can see this knob that says turn loop starter mode on or off. So simply click on that. Alright, it will generate a random sample for you. So now let's say you are targeting amapiano, you can simply change it to this point, or you are targeting EDM or hip-hop or techno. As you can see the list here, it has generated a sample. So let's preview it. And for some reason, if you don't like it, all you need to do is either come to the global randomizer here, click on it, and it will come up with a fresh idea. Amazing. So now, if you don't like Maybe you love this section and this one, but you don't like this. All you need to do is to come to the individual randomizer and click on that. It will come up with a fresh idea. I mean, this is mind-blowing. And then if you're satisfied with what you have, just simply drag it from here to your playlist by clicking on this. And voila, you have your loop ready to go. And with this, it's enough guide to help you start the project you want to work on. So let's have a final listen. Alright, let me show you another interesting feature here. And as you can see, when you generate a sample, it only comes in these three sections, right? So to fill in things here, let me quickly play it so that you see. Those are one-shot samples it will populate for you based on the genre you're working on, right? So let's say you want to fill it, but you still lack idea. All you need to do is to highlight them by holding down shift, clicking and dragging, then come over to this dice icon here, right-click, and click on generate steps for selected channels, and it will bring out these generated steps. Now, the magical thing here is when you play only these generated steps, you will see that it will complement whatever sample it has already generated for you here. So before then, let's just listen to only these ones here. All right, now let me introduce all these ones. Now, this is where things get crazier. This particular feature is more like having a ChatGPT inside FL Studio. Now, with this Gopher, you can literally learn everything you need to know about FL Studio, and you don't even need to ask anybody for assistance anymore. Let me show you. Come over to this section, click here. This menu comes out, and as you can see, Gopher is selected. So it's more like going for information you need to find out in FL Studio. So let's tell Gopher, how do I automate audio in playlist? So let's see what happens. And as you can see, it has given you detailed information on how to automate inside FL Studio. Feel free to read it. Right, let's find out something else. Give me a simple chord progression for hammer piano. Amazing. As you can see, it has given it to you. Certainly, hammer piano music often uses soulful, jazzy, and catchy chord progressions, typically in a minor key for warm, deep vibe. Here are some simple chord progressions you can try in FL Studio Piano Roll. See what it gave? And with this information, you already know what to do. So you can also use it to complete your song lyrics if you are losing ideas on what to write. ImageLine also introduced new plugins in this latest version 25. Emphasis is the new mastering limiter included with the All Plugins edition. It features multi-stage limiting with program-dependent timing, soft clipping, and true peak dictation. This plugin is clean, loud, and gives you pro-ready masters. Now, let's hear what ImageLine said about it.
With All Plugins Edition is our new multi-stage single-band mastering limiter built for easy and effective sound enhancement. A clean limiting stage with program-dependent timing allows for transparent dynamics. Then, the soft to hard clipping stage steps in, clipping off peaks while maintaining punch and clarity. A after that, there is a final brick wall limiting stage that can limit true peak signals, making sure your audio stays under the ceiling even when the second stage is working hard. With built-in LUFS metering, true peak detection, and oversampling, you can shape your mix with confidence.
FL Studio Mobile Rack lets you run FL Mobile plugins inside the desktop version of FL Studio. That is, 36 streamlined low CPU models you can automate and combine freely. And as you can see on the screen, these are the ones I've activated. And over here, you can see the list of available effect plugins you can try out. So let's check it out. FL Studio 25 also came with VFX Scripts. This feature gives you the ability to run live Python scripting inside Pacha. With this, you can create custom MIDI effects, automate parameters, or build new tools on the fly. Now, let's check out plugin updates. Classic FL plugins like Fruity Granulizer, Fruity Slicer, and other plugins now work inside Pacha, as you can see. And you also notice that plugin scaling is now consistent across everything. Clean, modern UIs too. So check out Drum Max, Sakura, and Bass Drum. Amazing. I mean, this is a huge one if you are familiar with creating plugins inside Pacha. The transporter plugin also got upgraded. According to ImageLine, the plugin got a routing boost. You can also send sidechain triggers separately, split loops across stereo outputs. Advanced routing mode made easy. Let's hear from ImageLine and see what they have to say about it.
Transporter has received new routing options. You can now allow a sidechain signal to trigger the transient detection, and you can also send the generated loops out to a separate stereo output. Bear in mind that when you do this, loop A will be panned hard left, and loop B will be panned hard right. So with the right stereo routing, you can get them on separate audio paths.
It is now very possible to remove reverb from your recorded vocals or any recorded element with the newly introduced feature in Edison called Edison De-Verb. Let's check it out.
We chase the stars, we touch the skies. We chase the stars, we touch the skies. We chase the stars, we chase the stars.
All right, these are the major new features and improvements in the latest version of FL Studio 2025 I want to share with you guys today. But there are still more, so feel free to try it out and see the remaining other features I didn't mention in this video. And let us know what you think about it in the comments below. And that will be it for today's video. If you found it helpful, make sure to leave a like, share your thoughts in the comments, subscribe, and most importantly, turn on your bell notification so that when next I upload videos like this, you get notified. As always, stay creative, stay focused, and I will see you in the next one. Bye for now.